This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for the table of contents and demonstrate how to create and update the table of contents. The table of contents heading must be centered without punctuation at the top margin. Headings and subheadings listed in the contents must be worded exactly as they appear in the manuscript, and all page numbers must correspond exactly with those in the manuscript. Entries should appear in the same font style as the body text, with no bold or italicized text in the table of contents. Chapter headings should be in all caps, with subheadings in title caps. Do not repeat the table of contents heading or use the word continued for multiple page lists. In the sample ETD, you can see that the table of contents only lists pages that follow the table of contents page. Sections appearing before the table of contents, including the table of contents header itself, should not be visible in the table of contents page. Each entry is linked, meaning that readers can either click the entry or the corresponding PDF bookmark to be taken to the page. It is important to update the table of contents when new content is added so that the page numbers will always match the content. Any deviations may result in rejection of the final document. I'll show you how to create and update the table of contents in the Word document. In the Word document, turn on the Show Hide All Formatting button so that you can see any pre-existing formatting. The heading should already have the pre-content style applied, as shown in the video tutorial for headings with the pre-content style. Press Enter to create a hard return after the heading. Now go to the References tab of the ribbon and select Table of Contents on the left side of the ribbon. From the drop-down menu, select Insert Table of Contents at the bottom of the menu. This gives you greater control over deciding what appears in the table of contents. To ensure that the table of contents only picks up headings with the Heading 1 style, choose Options. This menu lists all heading styles used in the document. It also has the Heading 1 style marked with a number 1, Heading 2 with a number 2, and so on. This indicates their hierarchical level within the table of contents. So the first level will be flush left, the second level will be indented, the third level indented further, and so on. Scroll down this list until you see the pre-content style. This style has also received a 1 because it is based on the Heading 1 style. Highlight the number 1 associated with it and press the backspace key to remove the number. Click OK. In the Table of Contents menu, be sure to check the box Use Hyperlinks instead of Page Numbers. This will create hyperlinks within your document so that readers can click a table of contents entry and be taken to the corresponding page. Click OK. Word should automatically generate the table of contents. You can test the links within the document by hovering your cursor over the entry and using Control plus click. If you add new content and page numbers have changed, you'll need to update the table of contents. There are two ways to do this. You can right-click the table of contents to open the editing menu. From here, select Update Field. In the menu that follows, choose Update Entire Table and press OK. You can also go to the References tab of the ribbon and choose the Update Table button to the right of the Table of Contents button. This will also update the entire table. This concludes the video tutorial for Table of Contents. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD help request form available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will cover the list of figures.